This class. Good morning, boys, all of you. Okay. Yeah, that's done. Today is 13th of August, okay, 2021. And we are doing the chapter study of compound sulfuric acid. Yesterday I had done 12 question answers. So today we'll go to the 13th one. Okay. Name from the list of substances given below the substances which you would use to prepare each of the following salts, named in parts 1 to 4. Okay. So, you have to choose from here. From here, you have to choose the answers. Okay. How to prepare zinc sulfate or prepare copper sulfate or sodium sulfate or lead sulfate. Okay. Now, the first one is zinc sulfate. How will you prepare zinc sulfate? For zinc sulfate, react zinc with dilute sulfuric acid. Zinc with dilute sulfuric acid. I'm writing over here, okay? Equation part. React zinc with dilute sulfuric acid. It forms zinc sulfate and liberates hydrogen gas. Okay, that is number 13, subpart A. Then subpart, the next one is number B, copper sulfate. So how to prepare copper sulfate? React copper oxide and dilute sulfuric acid. So copper oxide plus dilute sulfuric acid. So you will get copper sulfate plus water. Okay. Then number C, the third one, subpart 3, sodium sulfate. So to prepare sodium sulfate, react sodium carbonate solution with dilute sulfuric acid. So sodium carbonate solution, the formula is sodium carbonate Na2CO3 plus dilute sulfuric acid. Remember, if it is not mentioned anything over here beside an acid or above the acid, it is to be understood that it is dilute sulfuric acid. Okay. So here, when you react sodium carbonate with dilute sulfuric acid, the products obtained are sodium sulfate plus water plus carbon dioxide gas. Okay, that is number C. Now the fourth part is how to prepare what you call lead sulfate. Lead sulfate. So lead sulfate can be prepared by reacting lead carbonate with dilute nitric acid and then again dilute sulfuric acid. Okay, so first react lead carbonate with dilute nitric acid. PbCO3, lead carbonate with nitric acid, SNO3, in the first step. So here you will get lead nitrate plus water plus carbon dioxide. And after that, react this lead nitrate with what? With sulfuric acid. That is step, this is step one. Step one. And in step two, lead nitrate, it is reacted with dilute sulfuric acid to obtain lead sulfate plus nitric acid. Okay, so this is how you obtain the following salts: zinc sulfate, copper sulfate, zinc sodium sulfate, and lead sulfate. That is question number 13. Okay, I have written out the equations also. Sometimes you have to, yes.
So why are we not reacting lead carbonate directly with sulfuric acid? dilute sulfuric.
Because if you react lead carbonate with dilute sulfuric acid directly, no, then
yes, sir.
On the surface, on the first surface of lead carbonate, after reacting with sulfuric acid, an insoluble substance of lead sulfate is formed. Okay, which prevents
yes, sir.
Which prevents yes. The further reaction of sulfuric acid with the remaining lead carbonate which is inside. Are you getting it? Are you getting what I'm trying to say? Suppose if we take lead
yes,
carbonate, okay, this is lead carbonate, no? Lead carbonate, okay.
Yes, sir.
This lead carbonate will react with dilute sulfuric acid. See? The reaction will happen, but the reaction happened on the surface. So on the surface, there is a thick deposit of lead sulfate formed. Lead sulfate is formed. And then this lead sulfate is it's insoluble and it is unreactive. And it prevents the further reaction of this dilute sulfuric acid with the lead carbonate which is inside. It forms a protective coating. It forms a protective coating over the lead carbonate. So the reaction stops. That's why first we must prepare a soluble salt. Lead nitrate. And then only react with dilute sulfuric acid. Am I clear? That was a good question. Very good question. Okay. Now.
Yes, sir.
Shall we go to the next question? Shall we go to the next question? Okay. Now, look at the next slide.
Yes,
question number 14, okay? This is question number 14. Give examples of the use of sulfuric acid as an electrolyte in everyday use. In everyday use, we use dilute sulfuric acid in batteries. Can you hear me? Can you
yes,
hear
sir.
The voice? Okay. It is used in?
Yes,
lead accumulators or in storage batteries. That
Morning,
is
sir.
Use. Okay. And subpart 2, use of sulfuric acid as a non-volatile acid in the manufacture of other acids like nitric acid or hydrochloric acid or phosphoric acid also. Then as an oxidizing agent, it is used for cleaning metals before enameling, means painting, or electroplating, or galvanizing. Galvanizing means what? Coating with zinc. Coating with zinc metal means galvanizing. Okay. And pickling means cleaning. Pickling means again, it's a washing. It is a washing by using this acid. Okay. In the form of oxidizing agent. So, these are some common uses of sulfuric acid as an electrolyte in everyday use. Or a non-volatile acid or an oxidizing agent. Okay, that was question number 14. Now, shall I go to the next question? Shall I go to the next question, my dear boys? Okay. Look at the next slide. Question number 15 now. Question number 15, is it? Question number 15. Now, this is a question. It looks lengthy over here. Some of the properties of six pure substances represented by A, B, C, D, E, and F are given below. A, when heated with concentrated sulfuric acid, it gives off a choking gas which dissolves in water, giving an acid. That is A. The property of A is given. So A, when heated with concentrated sulfuric acid, gives off a choking gas. Choking gas means it chokes you from breathing. And this gas dissolves in water, giving an acid. So, A is that substance. So, I am just giving a guess over here. A could be sodium chloride. Okay. Now, B. B is a greenish yellow gas which dissolves in water, and when this equation and when this aqueous solution is exposed to sunlight, bubbles of a gas are evolved which rekindles a glowing splinter. So, the greenish yellow gas B is chlorine gas. Okay, this dissolved in water to give chlorine water, H2O plus Cl2. Now, when you expose this chlorine water to sunlight, then what happens? From that water, bubbles of oxygen gas is given out. Okay, so we'll come to the question after some time. The number C. C is a metal which, when treated with concentrated nitric acid, gives off a brown gas and a blue solution is obtained. So the metal C could be copper metal. It could be copper metal. The number D. D is a white solid which, when heated, gives off a sweet smelling gas which rekindles a glowing splinter. Okay, sir. Rekindling a glowing splinter means it has to be oxygen. So what is the sweet smelling white colored solid which is giving a sweet smelling gas? Let's find out after some time. Okay. Now.
Ammonium nitrate.
It is an explosive. Ammonium nitrate is an explosive. It is a white solid. It gives off a sweet smelling gas. What could be the sweet smelling gas? Tell me. Yes. Have you heard of laughing gas?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so we'll come to that after some time. Are you getting the hint already? E is a heavy oily liquid. In this chapter, the heavy oily liquid is strong sulfuric acid, which, when added to moist sugar, charges it into a black porous mass. So this E is what? It is concentrated sulfuric acid. Okay. Then F. F is a gas which turns moist red litmus paper blue. There is only one gas in your syllabus which turns moist red litmus paper blue. And when the gas is passed over heated copper oxide, reducing nature, an inactive gas is obtained. Inactive gas is nitrogen. So F could be ammonia gas. Ammonia is the only gas which is an alkaline gas which turns red litmus paper blue. So answers are given over here at the bottom. A is sodium chloride, B is chlorine gas, C is copper metal, D is ammonium nitrate, E is concentrated sulfuric acid, and F is ammonia gas. So subpart 1, all the answers are done. Okay. Then subpart 2, they are saying write equations for the following reactions A, B, C, D, E, and F. Okay, write equation for the reactions A, B, C, D, E, and F. So, how A is reacting, how B is reacting, how all those equations they are supposed to write. So, let us have a look at the equations on the next slide. Okay, the equations are on the next slide. Over here, sodium chloride, you can see sodium chloride, it is reacting with strong sulfuric acid to produce hydrogen chloride gas. This is the gas. If it dissolves this gas in water, it produces hydrochloric acid. Okay, that is the acid. Okay, now, number B. The second one is chlorine gas. Chlorine gas reacts with water in the presence of sunlight to liberate oxygen gas and hydrochloric acid is formed. So, if you react chlorine gas in water, it forms chlorine water and it contains HCl. HCl, hydrochloric acid dissolved in it. Okay, now, the gas which bubbles, rekindles a glowing splint is oxygen. So, this is what we have identified over here. Okay. The number B. Copper reacts with strong nitric acid to give copper nitrate blue in color. And then, reddish brown gas is nitrogen dioxide gas. Okay. Number C is ammonium nitrate. So, this gas is the sweet smelling gas. Okay. Sweet smelling gas. It is also called laughing gas. It is also called laughing gas because if this gas enters your system, then you feel like laughing. It tickles your body, you know. Continue laughing as long as the gas is in your system. Okay. So ammonium nitrate, if you eat it strongly,
can you go to the previous page?
Yeah. We're on previous page.
So I was going to the previous page. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
After that, number C is done. The next one is number D. Sugar crystals, when you react with concentrated sulfuric acid, okay, it becomes a black porous spongy mass due to the formation of carbon, okay, and then the sulfuric acid and water is expelled. Then number E, when ammonia is passed over heated copper to oxide, it is oxidized to form nitrogen and water. Nitrogen is formed, water is also formed. Okay, so copper 2 oxide reduces itself to metallic copper. copper to oxide is being it reduces it is reducing to metallic copper. So here the only alkaline gas which turns red litmus blue in your syllabus, red litmus blue in your syllabus is which gas? It is ammonia gas. It turns
ammonia.
Most red litmus blue. That is only gas. One man army. Okay, so this completes a question number 14, I guess. Okay. Am I clear, my dear boys?
Yes,
am
sir.
I clear? So please learn how to write the answer.
Yes, sir.
So yeah, see, I have done all the question writing also and answer also writing I have done for you. Just to teach you how to write the answers. Because our boys, you know, they lack in the method of writing the answers in a proper presentable manner. That is very important. Okay, now let us move to the next slide with a different set of questions. Okay, so look at the next slide, question number one. These are reasoning based questions. Okay, question number one. Why concentrated sulfuric acid is called oil of vitriol? Answer is given. Okay, concentrated sulfuric acid is called oil of vitriol because of its oily appearance and the fact that it is present in vitreous or glassy substances like ferrous sulfate or alum. Okay, that is the answer. Okay,
so what is alum?
Alum is you know, Pitcairn. You have heard of Pitcairn? Have you heard of Pitcairn?
Yes, sir.
Al2SO4 3 dot.
This is we can write 24H2. Look at this formula. This is the formula for alum, you know. Okay. Just a second. I'll write the. Just try to write it properly. Okay. It will help you. Let's write it properly. The formula. So eraser. Wait. I'll write a bigger formula. Okay. Okay. FeSO4 dot NS4 to SO4 dot, you can write 6H2 also. This is ferrous ammonium sulfate. This is also comes under the category of alum. Another one is K2SO4 dot Al2SO4 3 dot 24H2O. So this is also alum. Okay, this all comes under the category of alum. Okay, now the Pitcairn which I am talking about is this one, potash alum, potassium aluminium sulfate, and this one is called more salt. It is called more salt. Okay, so that is alum. Am I clear with that now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now come to question number two. Okay. Question number two. For the production of concentrated sulfuric acid, sulfur trioxide is not directly dissolved in water. Why? The reason is because with water, sulfur trioxide forms a mist of drops of sulfuric acid. Instead of forming liquid sulfuric acid, it forms vapors of sulfuric acid, and vapors of sulfuric acid are difficult to condense. They just don't condense easily. They condense very difficulty, with lot of difficulty. Okay. So that is the answer. Number three now. The impurity of arsenic oxide must be removed before passing the mixture of sulfur dioxide and air through the catalytic chamber in contact process. Why? Because the impurity, the spelling is wrong over there. Okay. The spelling is wrong. Impurity, let me make the I-M-P-U-R-I. I think that's correct now. Because the impurity of arsenic oxide makes the catalyst poisonous. So when a catalyst becomes poisoned, then the efficiency of the catalyst decreases. So that's why we prevent any impurities being present in the catalyst, okay, chamber. So that is answer number three. Question number four. Why concentrated sulfuric acid is kept in airtight bottles? This is an important question. Concentrated sulfuric acid is kept in airtight bottles. We keep it in airtight bottles because it gets auto-dilated. If the bottle is not tight, then it will absorb moisture from the surroundings and the atmosphere and becomes diluted on its own. Hence, it is kept in airtight bottles. Okay. That is the reason for keeping Kong sulfuric acid in airtight bottles. It absorbs moisture. Okay. Then question number 5 over here. Question number 5. Why the level of concentrated sulfuric acid gets higher if it is left in an open vessel for a week? That's too much, you know. That's too much. If you keep a Kong sulfuric acid bottle left open in an open vessel for a week, then the level will rise because it is what? It absorbs moisture. It is hygroscopic in nature. It absorbs moisture. This is due to the hygroscopic nature of sulfuric acid. It absorbs moisture, water vapor from the atmosphere and increases in volume. Okay, that you must remember. And question number 6. Explain why sulfuric acid behaves as an acid when diluted with water. So, when sulfuric acid is diluted with water, it ionizes almost completely into hydrogen ions and sulfate ions. And the presence of hydrogen ions imparts acidic character to the solution. Therefore, solution of sulfuric acid in water behaves as an acid. So that's the reason over here. The ionic equations are given over here. So, sulfuric acid is a dibasic acid producing 2 hydrogen ions per molecule. So, an acid is an acid because of its capability to produce hydrogen ions when it is dissolved in water. That is the reason why an acid is an acid. And rightly said over here, sulfuric acid behaves as an acid when dissolved, when diluted with water. Okay, that was question number 6. Okay, now let us move to our next slide. So, going to our next slide, this question 6 is over now. Looking at the next slide, question number 7. Now, if you, I don't know last year whether you went to the lab or not, but before that, in class 8, have
yes,
you
sir,
been
time.
To the lab? One time, no.
So yes, sir. So, you made us smell that some. That.
No, I only
yes, sir,
for you.
I took you all.
No, yes, sir. So you
yes,
sir,
you
that
took us.
Something that
so section C has not been to lab.
Okay. You didn't take us.
Okay,
you didn't take us.
Because I did not teach you. No?
Section C did not go.
I was not
section B has gone.
So our bad luck.
Okay, never mind, never mind, never mind. Don't worry, don't cry. Okay, I'll take you.
Huh?
Let's pray that the pandemic is over, okay? Everything is normal, then definitely we are going to the lab very badly. You know? All the theory classes will be converted into practical classes, you know, after that. You know, because once everything is normal,
yes, sir.
Once all of us are in the school, I'll make sure all the theory classes are spent in the chemistry lab only. No teaching theory, only doing practicals. Okay, because I will complete the syllabus before that. Okay,
wow.
Understood? No, understood? No,
yes, sir.
Thank you,
yes,
sir.
Okay, so,
yes, sir.
Yes,
sir.
Look at question number 7.
Thank you.
Why the wooden shelves on which Kong sulfuric acid bottles are kept, they are stained black in color. I think you must have noticed some racks are black in color. They have turned black. Where the, you know, wherever the sulfuric acid bottle is kept, no, that portion has turned black. If this is the table, you know, the top surface of the table on which sulfuric acid has been kept, it turns black after some days, you know, because wood. It is one form of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, okay? So that comes under cellulose, so it reacts with the Kong sulfuric acid and becomes charred, becomes black, stained black, okay? So answer is given, Kong sulfuric acid is a very, very powerful acid. It is a very, very powerful dehydrating agent. It removes atoms of hydrogen and oxygen from where? Atoms of hydrogen and oxygen in the form of water from the cellulose. The general formula is given. C6H12O5 outside the bracket N. N stands for a natural number, leaving behind carbon. And this, whatever is left behind that carbon, this is black in color. That's why that the rack on which Kong sulfuric acid has been kept, it appears black. Is that clear? Is that clear, my dear boys? All of you are dear to me.
Yes, sir.
Okay, question number 8 now.
Yes, sir.
Now, if you look at question number 8 over there, again, it is a similar question asked in another form. Same question in another form. You know, I can ask every question in 4 different ways. North, south, east and west. So, this is one of the forms. A black spongy mass is formed when concentrated sulfuric acid is added to sugar. Why? Okay, so again, you can see sugar with sulfuric acid over here. It forms sugar charcoal. It is a black spongy mass and water is expelled. Okay, now sulfuric acid, we know it has a great lovingness for water. Hence, when concentrated sulfuric acid is added to sugar, it absorbs water from sugar by removing the hydrogen oxygen atoms in the ratio 2:1 from sugar molecules. The sugar is charred, producing black spongy mass of carbon, which is known as sugar charcoal. Okay, so this is how you write the answer for question number 8. Okay, now moving to the next slide. Again, question number 9 on your screen. When blue crystals of copper 2 sulfate are added to concentrated sulfuric acid, the crystals turn white in color. The crystals turn white. Why? Because this sulfuric acid, it is a dehydrating agent. It removes water as a molecule from substances. It removes water as a molecule. So the 5 water molecules which are present as water of crystallization in the blue crystals of copper sulfate hydrated are removed, producing anhydrous copper sulfate, which is white in color. So that is the answer. Okay. So the water of crystallization is lost from the hydrated copper sulfate blue colored crystals. That's why it becomes white crystals, or you can say anhydrous copper sulfate. Okay. Actually, this is not exactly white crystals. It is white anhydrous powder. It is exactly white anhydrous anhydrous, A-N-H-Y-D-R-O-U-S, anhydrous powder. It is a white anhydrous powder. Okay. Copper sulfate, it's a white anhydrous powder, you can see. Now, question number 10, why brisk effervescence, spelling, I don't know, it's correct, I think. Why brisk effervescence? Let us check the spelling. Okay. What happened? Okay. Yeah, now it's correct. Why brisk effervescence is seen? You know what is effervescence? You know what is effervescence, all of you? Have you opened a bottle of effervescence? Meaning of effervescence?
Bubbling,
yes. Very fast.
Soda.
Yes, when you open a bottle of soda or a cold drinks, okay, then bubbles rise out from the bottom of the container. They move upwards, no? Very fast. That movement,
yes,
that activity is called effervescence. Yes, so, why brisk effervescence is seen when sulfuric acid dilute is added to sodium carbonate? So, when you add dilute sulfuric acid to sodium carbonate, okay, you know Mentos, you know what is Mentos?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Mentos is a
yes,
carbonate
sir.
Salt.
Magnesium yes, sir.
Carbonate.
Toffee.
Are there, no? Mentos carbonate. These are what? Magnesium carbonate salts, sodium carbonate salts, all mixed together. That's why it has a nice minty taste. The minty taste. So, to this sodium carbonate, if we add dilute sulfuric acid, then
Coca-Cola.
You get a brisk effervescence. That is due to the evolution of gas, due to the evolution of gas, and the gas is carbon dioxide gas. The gas which comes out is what? It is carbon dioxide gas. Along with carbon dioxide, the other products are sodium sulfate and water also. Okay, and the main gas responsible for the effervescence is carbon dioxide gas. Okay, that's why we see a brisk effervescence when dilute sulfuric acid is added to sodium carbonate salt. Okay, so I think question number 10 is clear to all of you. Okay, so let us move to the next question quickly. I want to complete the question answers today. Now moving to the next slide, we have on a screen chemical test. Okay, chemical test. Question, there is two questions over here. Number one, a dilute sulfuric acid and dilute hydrochloric acid. How will you do a test to distinguish between these two acids? So first one answer, when barium chloride solution is added to dilute sulfuric acid, then a thick white precipitate of barium sulfate is formed, which is insoluble in any mineral acid such as nitric acid or hydrochloric acid. So this is the test for what? This is a precipitate. Okay, this is a test for, this is the equation for testing dilute sulfuric acid. Okay, with dilute hydrochloric acid, no effect is observed. That is number one. This is answer number one. And answer number two over here, chlorine water and sulfur dioxide gas. Chlorine gas and sulfur dioxide gas. Chlorine gas turns starch iodide paper blue. Learn this. Very, very important. Chlorine gas turns starch iodide paper blue. It is oxidizing in nature. Whereas sulfur dioxide gas turns moist acidified potassium dichromate paper from orange to green. From what? Orange, O-R-A-N-G, orange to green. So, sulfur dioxide gas turns moist acidified potassium dichromate paper from orange to green. Okay. Whereas chlorine gas turns starch iodide paper blue. That means chlorine will not show the test which sulfur dioxide shows, and sulfur dioxide will not show the test which chlorine gas shows. So that is how you distinguish between these two questions. Okay. Now we have some questions where we are supposed to write chemical equations. Okay. So there are 20 equations on this slide. 20 equations on this slide. You can see on your slide over there. I'll not read anything over here. This is just a question. You can copy it down. And on the next slide, I've given the answers for all of them. Okay, so I will not read them out or balance them or write down these equations. Okay, H2. Okay, let's just check one over there. H2, this one is oleum. This one is oleum formula. H2S2O7. Okay, let's check this formula from the book itself. Oh, that is oleum. Or pyrosulfuric acid. Rest is correct. So the question answers from this chapter are complete. And from your textbooks after the chapter, you try and solve on your own ICC questions. The years are 2016, 2017, 2018. 2019 and 2020. This many ICC questions, you solve it from the book only at the end of the chapter, because now I've given you most question answers, so you'll get all the answers from whatever questions I've given. After that, additional questions you solve, some of the additional questions also you solve from the textbook itself. Okay, just select the important ones on your own, and then there is a test paper at the back of the chapter, of this chapter, sulfuric acid. That test paper also, you solve the fill in the blanks, one word questions, okay, and match the column, okay, and that will help you prepare for this chapter. Okay, so this chapter is complete, my dear boys. So now I will record your attendance first, then only you may leave the class and go for your break. Okay, just hang on over there for some time, okay, don't go away. Your attendance is recorded. There are 87 attendees, including me. So it is done. So you may leave the class. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.
Thank you, sir. Bye.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.